Services are a great way to make your application easier to maintain and adapt to new requirements. Today, I'll teach you how to create services within the Symfony 4 framework. This assumes that you already have some familiarity with Symfony. In this short tutorial, we will create a service to fetch your content from an external CMS. We will configure it in a way to make it work in any environment. We will then make it easy to switch between different CMSs without changing all your controllers. Alright, let's do this. Under Source, let's create a folder called Service. This is where we'll put all our services. Now let's create cockpitcms.php. It will be used to communicate with a simple CMS running on my machine to fetch various content. Let's add a namespace in class. Create a single method getList that will return an array. Most CMSs fetch items by a collection name. Add this as a string parameter. Now add optional filters in case we want to constrain our search. We'll grab the data using curl. My CMS is running on localhost port 8080. We'll add the collection variable and our token. We'll later change this code to use a URL in token from the configuration. Set the return transfer option, execute, and close. Decode the JSON and return just the entries portion without all the metadata. In our controller, we'll add the CMS as a parameter. We'll grab the items from the product collection, then just pass them to the template. In the CMS, I already created some entries for the product collection. This application is running locally on my machine on a different URL. The data is exposed using a JSON API. Back in our application, let's go to the products page. We can see the products displayed correctly. Symfony automatically wired everything together for us, so we don't need to instantiate the service ourselves. Now we can reuse that CMS service in all the controllers that need it. But we're not quite done yet. We can configure the CMS service so that the base path and token come from the environment. This way, we can run it locally as well as remotely, while also not storing any secret keys in our codebase. We start by adding two variables to our .env file at the root of the project. These will obviously be set to different values in our production environment. Now open the services.yaml file. At the bottom, add a service called cms.cockpit. Specify the class and pass two arguments to the constructor, the same ones that we defined earlier. Now back to our service class. Add two private properties. Add a constructor that will set them. Now, we just need to replace the hard-coded values in the URL. Still works, but it's now much cleaner in the code. But what happens if you decide to switch from Cockpit to another CMS? This actually happens quite often in my projects, but requires changing all the controllers. Let's make the CMS easy to replace by implementing an interface for our service. Under Source, create a folder named Interfaces. Make sure to make it plural to avoid collision with a reserved keyword. Declare the namespace and create the interface. Add a single method getList with the exact same arguments and return type as the one we used in the service. Now make the service implement that interface. Go back to the controller and use the newly created interface instead of the concrete class. Now we need to make sure that whenever CMS interface is requested, the Cockpit CMS service gets instantiated. Back in the services.yaml file, add the interface and point it to the name of the service below. Let's do a quick recap of how the service gets instantiated. The product controller, via the type hint, requests an instance of CMS interface. The configuration in services.yaml maps the interface to the cms.cockpit service. The configuration then pulls the environment variables and provides them to the constructor. A Cockpit CMS instance is supplied to the controller. All the legwork is done by the framework before the product controller is executed. So how do we swap one implementation for another? Just create another service called OtherCMS. Implement the same interface. Let's get the method to return a hard-coded list of entries. Now, in the YAML file, you can put that class directly, since we don't need to configure any arguments. And that's it! We're seeing the entries from our other CMS. Services can be useful in many cases, such as content providers, payment gateways, or cloud storage. I personally use it for almost anything to make my application easier to modify. I even use it as a wrapper for most plugins I install, so that I can later switch the plugin if I decide that it doesn't do what I need. It's very little effort that saves a lot of work down the line, because our applications and business needs evolve over time. Thank you for watching and happy coding! Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, check out my workshops in the description below.